It's a Wonderful Life is an incredibly genuine, incredibly brave film for Capra to undertake after World War II, because he has gone through an incredible experience where he has given so much for others in the way he sees his own labor. And he comes out of it, and it's inconsequential in the same quiet, terrible way that George Bailey postpones his trips, postpones his life.
Uh-oh.
Please, let's not stop, George.
I'll be back in a minute.
In order to serve a community of people that render him, in his perception, invisible. The essence of Capra is always a question of worth, a question of self-worth.
Dear Father in Heaven.
It's a true contemplation in which, you know, Capra asks himself what the world would be without me.
You're driving me crazy, too. I'm seeing things here. I'm going home and see my wife and family. You understand that? And I'm going home alone.
The abandonment of George Bailey is truly existential. That is as dark as he can get. I think he really faces the darkest part of the mirror in that film. Many filmmakers, even if they remain active, create their testament movie at an earlier point in their career. And then they go on working, but not necessarily renovating themselves. And I think It's a Wonderful Life rephrases Capra. He truly ventures something that intimate, truly himself, out there on a limb.
I want to live again. Please, God, let me live again.
Kids, Jamie!
It's not only a film that is remembered and loved, but it's part of a season. It's part of a yearly ritual in every family, in every country in the world.
George! George,
Mary.
Darling, where are you? George, darling, where are you? Oh, George!